Yeah. Good morning, everyone, Andy. So today we are going to have this session by Banu Garu. He's the fastest human calculator. And let's see like a couple of things about him. He's joining our session soon. So if you see like Banu Garu, he at the age of 10, he possesses like a hall math tournament trophies. In 2010 itself. So look at the picture, like so many things he got, so many tournament trophies and all that. And if someone asks this number, 869-463-853x73, an average person like me or anyone else, oh, it takes so much time, right? Like, so the Banu Garu has answered that in just 20 seconds, and it's 634708. I'm just reading the number, but he does that in his brain, like in his head. So that makes him the world's fastest human calculator. And see, at the age of 20, he won the world's fastest human calculator title. And this is the first ever gold for our India in the Mental Calculation World Championship conducted by Mind Sports Olympiad in London, August of the last year. So in this competition, if you see like he beat 29 opponents from 13 countries to take the gold. And his speed is so extraordinary, and the judges has to make additional things to him to confirm his accuracy. And he got all that. And along with that one, he's holding 4 world records, 50 Limca Bukov records, and he's also TEDx speaker and educator. And he's doing so many projects. He has developing arithmetical skills in students across the globe. He addresses several audiences in 23 countries. And the Commonwealth Conclaves, Future City Summits, ISBs, IITs, and multiple globe institutions. And he meets about the importance of arithmetic learning overall development of the child. He states, okay, I don't want to be the face of mathematics. And he says like, there are enough of those and they're also exceptional. And he want to be the face against math phobia. Wow, that is awesome. And he's very simple. So we from the Telugu Association of St. Louis, sorry. Welcome, Banu Garu. Thank you, Banu Garu, for your time and joining our session. We not only have Telugu members in this session, we have like so many of our friends from other associations, from North America and from India, from across the globe. And please provide your valuable inputs. Naidu Garu, can you please host Banu Garu?
Yeah, thanks, Andy Raja Garu. So just let me mark Banu Garu as
yes, sir. I can speak. No problem.
Oh, you can. Yeah. Hi. Okay. Yeah. Thanks.
Yeah. Go ahead. Maybe, sir, if you can pass on your co-host so that I can share my screen as well.
That's what I'm thinking. Yeah. Sure. 1 minute. Yeah.
Sure. Hello, guys. Hope you're all doing fine. Meanwhile, as sir progresses and stops screen sharing, maybe I'll quickly introduce myself. Just a minute. Excited to be here. And once I can start screen sharing, I'll start off with this 2-day webinar. And I'm sure every one of you understands that it's for 2 days, where the first day is more of a display of showing you guys what I'm capable of doing and how do I do it. And the second, to talk about how math can be fun for every single one of you. So Rajagar, if you can stop sharing your screen, that'll be great. Maybe. Great. And I'm yet to get the credentials to screen share. That's okay. Hello, everyone. Hope you're all doing well. And good morning to you guys. It's a little in the evening here. I am Nilakata Vanaprakash, and I am the world's fastest human calculator. What that means is that I hold a bunch of world records which can, where I've raced past the speed of a calculator, if you know. And how many of you here have watched the movie Shakuntala Devi? Have you? Anyone? Yeah. I broke four of her world records recently, right? I broke four of her world records to be quicker than her in calculations. And I'm here to teach you guys or tell you guys how you can start that journey. Yeah. How many of you are excited? How many of you want to learn how to be quicker and better at math? Yeah. Okay, that's a lot of raise of hands. I also want to ask you a couple of questions, guys. How many of you like mathematics? How many of you are like, no, it's boring? It's a lot of people. I know that there are a lot of people. No, just do this if it's no. Okay. I see a bunch of people who are like middle, somewhere in middle. Okay. Setu says same. Somewhere in middle. Okay. Great. So in this journey of 2 days, guys, I hope you attend today and tomorrow. I'm going to tell you how I'm broadly going to go, right? Today is going to be the show. I'm going to show you how a human brain can do the impossible, okay? Yeah? And tomorrow is when you'll understand how to achieve that impossible. Does that make sense? Today, we'll go through what I can do and run you through a little bit of story on narrative on how mathematics came into existence. So today's going to be more of a fun sort of a, hey, let's enjoy. Let's challenge Banu into making him do a bunch of things. And tomorrow, at the same time, I'll teach you guys how to do quick calculations as a start, right? Before I start off this, I want to tell every one of you, I'm 21 years old, not very old. I have been like you guys on the other side of the classroom for a long time. So I'm happy to answer anything which you guys have put in the comment section, and I'm more than chill, right? I'm not, let's say, here to teach you, oh, okay, this is how we learn, right? Math is about how we make it fun. You see the guy here on my background, it's about the guy who's actually having the idea, training his brain, and also becoming four times quicker at calculations. That's what we'll try to do to everyone, okay? I'll probably start off by having a couple of volunteers from your side who have a phone or a calculator with them. Who does? Anyone? Can raise your hand, maybe?
I have one.
Okay, okay, you have one. You've unmuted. Let's go on with it. Let me also unmute Nikhit, because I think he is sort of put that. Nikhit, can you unmute yourself?
Yes.
Yeah, Nikhit, can you open the calculator in front of you or whatever? Just open a calculator. Okay, if it's on your phone, then it's okay. Anyone who was, yeah, okay, something else. Cool. So what I want you to do is, Nikhit, give me a 5-digit okay. number. Give me a 5-digit number, a big
5862.
Okay, one more. Five digits. You're giving me 4 digits. 5862 what? And one more number.
95862.
95862 multiplied by, give me another 5-digit number.
Okay. 4 3 8 2 1.
How long do you think I'm gonna take to do this?
I think 30 seconds.
Okay, guys, all of you type this into your comment section. I will start doing this now. 95862 multiplied by 43821. Now that answer is going to be 420 crore. I mean, if I have to put it, 420, 7,68,702. It's 4,200,768,702. Is that correct?
Yes.
Thank you. Right? I did it in under 6 to 7 seconds, I think 10 seconds from what I've seen from people to say. Fantastic. Thanks a lot. Now, what I'm going to do is, thanks, Nikhit, is I'm going to try to make this one step ahead and tell you how I do this, my calculation, a little while. But maybe anyone else who can volunteer? Anyone who else? Can you raise your hand on the video only? Don't. Raise your hand on the Zoom app. I'm going to unmute you. Okay, Chakshu.
Yeah.
Chakshu, what I want you to do is give me a 4-digit number.
Okay.
And everyone else, you can try it as well. Chakshu, give me a 4-digit number.
It would be 4569.
Okay, 4569 multiplied by another 4-digit number.
7, 8, 5, 6.
Okay, I'm going to get the answer and I'm going to divide it with a two-digit number. Chakshu, give me a two-digit number.
A two-digit number of 52.
Okay, the multiplication and then dividing by 52 is going to give you 690,270.46153. Is that the answer?
For the what?
Huh?
Let me see that. I can't get it for some. Okay.
690,270.46153.
And then let me do divided by.
So Vivek is showing you. Yeah, that is the answer. Vivek. Vivek, turn the iPhone sort of a calculator. You'll get more digits.
Yeah, I got it.
46153. Absolutely correct. So thank you. Thanks a lot. What I'm trying to tell you guys is, would you believe me if I told you that a human brain can do quicker calculations than a calculator now? Yeah?
Yes.
To a certain extent, yes. Sure. I mean, there are limitations. I do understand. But let's see. Let's actually take this ahead. Who here thinks that they can type quickly? Okay, Arjun. I'm going to take Arjun's the first name which I've seen. Arjun.
Can you hear me?
Hey, Arjun. Yeah, Arjun, can you take a phone and open the calculator in it?
Yeah.
Arjun, what I want you to do is give me a two-digit number. Any two-digit number.
29.
Okay. What I want you to do, Arjun, is take 29 and add 29s to itself. Can you do that? 29 plus 29 plus 29. Can you do that?
Okay.
29 plus 29 is 58, plus 29 is 87, plus 29 is 116. Can you keep doing that?
Yeah.
Clear it off. No, clear it off. Let's start together. That's what I'm trying to say, okay? 3, 2, 1, go. Arjun, start. 29, 58, 87, 116, 145, 174, 203, 231, 203, 232, 261, 293, 193, 348, 348, 377, 406, 435, 464, 493, 521, 551, 586, 609, 638, 667, 696, 725, 754, 783, 812, 841, 870, 899, 928, 957, 986, 1015, 1044, 1073, 1102, 131, 11160, 1189, 1218, 1247, 1276, 1305, 1334, 1363, 1392, 1421, 1450. That's 50 times.
I feel like you're just too fast.
I couldn't calculate that fast.
Yeah. What I'm trying to tell you, go ahead.
Last number?
1450. I stopped at 15 times. 1450. So you can actually take 1450 divided by 50, divided by 29. That'll be 50 times. But there might be a chance that I memorized this, right? There can be a chance. There is a chance. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take, let's say, someone else who's probably here. Switch on your, let's say, phone's calculator. And I'm going to probably pick Abhi. Abhi?
Yeah.
Yeah, Abhi, what I want you to do is I want you to give me two numbers. Two two-digit numbers.
54.
Okay.
And 23.
What I'm going to do, Abhi, is I'm going to take 54 and start adding 23s from there. So there's no chance that I actually know this, right? This is called an arithmetic progression. And anyone here who has a calculator, you can try this. And this is going to, let's say, 54 plus 23 plus 23 plus 23 and go on, right? I'm going to start. And this is two numbers which I have no idea of, right? I'm going to start. 54, 77, 100, 123, 146, 169, 192, 215, 238, 261, 284, 307, 333, 53, 376, 399, 422, 445. I'm talking to you. I'm still doing my calculations on the back of my mind. I'm at 606, 629, 652, 675, 698, 721, 744, 716, 790. I'm continuing to do so. And I'm at 1120, 1120, and I can continue, 1020 and so on, right? So the idea is that the human brain can be quicker than a calculator. Yeah. But that is if you train it well. Yeah. Just like how a human body can do unimaginable things. Let's say build out a toned muscle, build out something which you have not imagined, probably build out a six pack or whatever. Right. But the brain can do that too, which is that your brain can actually turn into a superhero. And my example for doing this would be simple. I just want you guys to type in the longest number you can think of in the comment section. Don't type all nines, but type in the longest number you can think of. Just the longest number.
Can we write 3.15 like pi?
No, but pi is different, right? Pi is an irrational number. I can do that. I mean, that's more of memory. There's no calculation in that. Yeah, just type a random number which is very long. That's what I would say. Suggest you guys to do. Okay, I'm going to take Vihan's number. Vivan or Vihan? I'm not sure. Okay, just guys, chill. I've gotten numbers now. I'm just going to take the longest number which I've gotten so far. Okay, I'm going to take Satya's number, which is very huge. Satya, I've taken your number, okay? And let's see if I can put this in front of you guys. See how big this number is. Do you see how big this number is, guys? Everyone? Cool. What I'm going to do, guys, is I'm going to multiply this with a number. Can anyone of you give me a number between 2 and 9? Any number between 2 and 9?
Me.
Okay, I've gotten 6. I'm going to take 6. I'm going to cancel the E in between because it doesn't matter, okay? E is not a number. The rest is fine, okay? How long do you think I'm going to take to do this?
4 seconds.
Comment section, guys. Comment
about
section.
30 seconds.
1 second.
1 minute. 1 minute, 30 seconds. I'm going to start doing this. The answer is 1 4 8 4 8 4 5 9 8 6 2 6 7 1 4 5 0 4 0 8 9 1 4 3 4 7 1 7 8 0 8 5 1 4 1 2 0 9 7 9 4 6 9 4 7 0 4 7 8 0 5 3 4 0 4 6 1 3 4 7 8 0 5 3 4 0 4 6 1 3 4 7 0 7 8 0 8 5 1 4 1 2 0 9 7 9 4 6 4 7 0 7 3 7 3 8 0 9 8 7 1 3 0 7 9 4 7 7 8 0 9 2 5 9 9 5 0 4 8 0 7 1 2 1 8 0 6 1 9 0
and that's the answer.
The way I've done this, guys.
I think if we put that question in the calculator,
it doesn't work.
I think if we put that question in the calculator, it might break.
Yeah, but the calculator will give you an error, guys. The calculator will give you an E because the calculator cannot handle. At least a normal calculator. Scientific calculators can calculate, but a normal calculator will not be in a position to do this calculation. Right? It'll do only a 12-digit calculation. And the same calculation can be done in a very different way. But if you see that there are fundamental 2-3 differences, that I did the calculation from the left to the right. Yeah? Yeah? And I think someone else actually pointed it out in the comment section. Aryan did. I have read the question in the direction in which I started answering my answer. Do you see that? Did you observe it? Now, let's say tomorrow, let's say when we have a question of our own to answer or handle, we usually do this 87 into 6. We do 6 into 7, 2, 4 carried, 8, and 52, which itself is difficult because you need to do carry. But I did the answer as it is. Yeah? In the direction in which it is read in, which is what is the secret towards doing speed calculations. Okay? Now, with this, I'm going to start on to you telling you guys about the journey of mathematics and majorly what is important and what is not important. Okay? What is important and what is not in math? Let me start off with this, a small storyline which talks about this guy. Let's say there is this guy who can run for a 100 meter race, guys, 100 meters race in 9.2 seconds and has a world record for this. Can you tell me who this guy is? World records, a lot of gold medals as the quickest man on earth. Can any of you tell me who this guy is? Okay, Bhuvan told me the answer, but I probably want to get the first name and the last name. Okay, this is Usain Bolt. Yeah? Now, Usain Bolt is the fastest man alive. Do you guys agree to that? Fastest man alive who can run quicker than anyone else. Yeah? Now, how does he do it? Can you tell me how does he do it? How is he so quick? Okay, Flash is not a real person, guys. Okay, cool. So, he trains, sure. He practices, trains. He has a good diet. He exercises. Okay. Willpower, someone said. That's good. Okay. What else? Runs. Okay. Has proteins and good diet. I think that's there. Perseverance, someone said. I mean, yeah, that's a quantitative, nice way to look at. Bunch of things, right? There is, he sort of trains his body not only by running again and again, but by actually doing things which you can't even imagine, like in general, running for huge laps or whatever, and becomes so quick. Now, my question to you guys would be that if there is another person, guys, let's say this guy is another new dude, okay? It's a new guy. This guy goes for the same 100 meters, say, in 2 seconds. Can you imagine? Just 2 seconds. This new guy comes out of nowhere, goes in 2 seconds, but he goes in a car. Okay? He goes in a car. Now, can you tell me how, or let's call this guy Peter, okay? Now, how is Peter getting there in two seconds? What is he doing? What is Peter doing? Peter is using a machine. Okay. Can't really say cheating because his objective might be very different. He's using a shortcut. Okay. Yeah, you can say he's using a car, which is like a trick or whatever, right? Sure. Now, okay, Bugatti, sure. It need not be a Bugatti. You can do that in a Honda car also. You can do this in a Peugeot. There's no requirement of Bugatti to go for 100 meters in 2 seconds. Okay, cool. Now, what I want you to tell you is one question. Who is the better one? Let's say tomorrow, if we put a competition between Usain Bolt and Peter in swimming, who do you think will win? Yeah, I just want every one of you to answer. I'm just going to wait until I get around 80 answers in the comment section. UB, you can just type in UB. You don't have to type Usain Bolt or whatever. UB is fine. Or U is also fine. Okay. Right? Fantastic. The reason why Usain Bolt is better is because he's actually doing the job. Yeah? Where let's say Peter is just using a shortcut. Huh? Do you understand this? Now, similarly, guys, in a similar sense. In a similar sense, I'm just going to use this here. I'm going to tell. Similarly, let's say this is a person who is doing a calculation, okay? This is you doing a calculation. Now, let's say the calculation is something like 25 into 100. What is 25 into 100, guys? Suhas says Peter cheater. Yeah, Peter cheater, pumpkin eater. Sure, cool. 2500. Yeah, absolutely. How many of you are actually doing this calculation? Are we really doing this calculation? Are we really multiplying 25 by 100 or are we just putting the two zeros there? We're just putting the two zeros there, right? Which means that we're using a shortcut. In a similar sense, can I also say that some people who say 25 into 25, how many of you know a trick to do 25 into 25? You multiply 2 with the next number, which is 6, 2 into 3, and then put the 25 next to it as it is, which is the answer. Some people say that this is whatever. Now, the idea is that once you use a trick or a shortcut, and you know what shortcuts can be? Shortcuts can be abacus. Have you heard of abacus, guys? Yeah. Can be Vedic math. Have you heard of Vedic math? It's okay if you haven't. You're not missing out on a lot. Have you heard on, what do we say, repeated, whatever, I mean, these two. And then let's say, abacus, or let's say using a calculator by itself, right? Just using a calculator by itself. Yeah. Now these three are shortcuts and tricks. Do you understand? Now, can this person, let's say this guy's name is Ram. Okay. Can Ram really do well in algebra later? If he's using, let's say, abacus or calculation, whatever. Can he do better in geometry? Can he do better in coding? Not really. Okay. Now, yes and no is a very weird answer to give. But what I'm telling you is that Ram is not training his brain, just like how Peter was not training his body. Okay. Now, you might say, No, no, I will use my calculator. Yes, we should all. I also use a calculator. Okay? I also use my calculator. You know why? Because even if Usain Bolt wants to run from Washington to Illinois, right? If he wants to run from Washington to Los Angeles, he'll not run, right? He'll go in a car or a flight. He'll take a shortcut. Because you won't use that everywhere. But to train, he'll not go in a car. Does that make sense? To train himself, he will take and use the actual factual understanding of the human body, which is what I want every one of you to understand. That if you learn math, you need to learn math the Usain Bolt way, not the Peter way, okay? Which means that you should not run behind tricks, but you should run behind what can make you quicker at math by building some skills, which I call the cognitive abilities. What are cognitive abilities? I mean, I'm going to briefly run you through. How many of you know what stuff is there in a computer? There's some parts in a computer, right? Like what, I don't know. A Google is not a part of the computer. I'm talking about physical parts, guys, like whatever. I mean, the motherboard. Okay, cool. The processor, the keyboard, the mouse. Yeah. The bunch of things, the memory, there's RAM, there's hard disk, if you know. So a computer's speed is determined by its RAM or processor, and its capacity to hold is defined by something called its hard disk. Yes? You can call it hard disk, you can call it internal memory on your phone, on your iPhone or whatever, on your iPad. You call it internal memory. Yeah? The M1 chip in your iPad is the processor. The 128 GB is your storage. Yeah? So a computer has parts, right? In a similar way, the brain has a certain qualities called cognitive abilities, which is the ability of the brain to calculate, the ability of the brain to remember, the ability of the brain to remember and quickly run through stuff. So these are some things which you need to develop. And these won't be developed if you're using a shortcut. Does that make sense? Just like how Usain Bolt's running trains himself in his body, in terms of his legs, in terms of his muscle, in terms of his breath, in terms of his physique, in terms of his what do we say, health and stuff like this, right? Not only him, in terms of any athlete for that matter, right? Can be Ronaldo, can be Messi, can be anyone, right? So that's important. So I hope you understand why we are doing calculations. We are not doing calculations to come to the solution, because the solution is not that important. What's more important is that you're running. Yeah? That you're actually training your brain. Okay? That's the most important part. And yeah, I mean, I would probably say that when I do my calculations, I actually feel like I am like a flash or something, right? I do feel that because I do see how my brain is calculating so quickly. I'll actually show you an example. Yeah? I'll show you an example where I'm going to tell you how these calculations can change the way you think. And maybe after a little bit, I'm going to open it out for you guys, the questions and stuff like that. No one can calculate with infinity, guys. I mean, someone's asking me, can you calculate with infinity? That's just bizarre. Just give me a second. I'm going to do something which is going to be very impressive for you guys to see. Guys, what I'm going to do is I'm going to share onto the screen a blank page. Okay. Are you going to see this? What is going to happen is that there are going to be numbers coming onto the screen. Okay. And going away. And I'll try to add them in front of you. Okay. Like numbers are going to come up in the screen like this and go away. And I'm going to try to add them all. Okay. And I'm going to show you how quickly I can do this. See. 59, 91, 188, 222, 278, 369, 391, 404, 497, 563, 628, 682, 730, 815, 875 is the answer. I think I missed it. Let's try again. 70, 109, 138, 219, 244, 343, 389, 450, 483, 541, 619, 647, 733, 779, 830. Correct, right? What I did is that I was looking into these calculations and trying to calculate them as quickly as possible. And I'm going to show you how this can be much quicker than this. Let me show. 3, 2, 1 and go. I'm talking to you guys and I'm doing this calculation on the back of my mind, which means that my brain is multitasking right now. 633. I am doing these calculations in front of you adding them and talking to you guys and looking at how you guys are smiling, and I'm gonna probably get the five correct answer again, 506. Hope it is correct, right? Which means that your brain right here can do stuff which you can't even imagine. Yeah? Which means that we have a few things which it's like the Flash, right? Suddenly it starts running at the speed of light. But for that, there is something superhuman which happens. But I'm saying that you can start off this journey too in not a very, 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 very hard way. And there is no ultimate secret to this. The ultimate secret lies in how you understand mathematics. And this is for every parent who's here, probably in this session, looking at this. You might say, this is the whole point of why I'm trying to establish that math can be fun. And more importantly, now on, you'll see how this can be achieved, because over 1,000 children at Exploring Infinity so far have become 4 times quicker than what they were. Not by learning tricks, not by learning shortcuts, not by learning abacus, but by learning a few fundamental ways of thinking about numbers. And I'm going to show you one fundamental way today. Yeah. One fundamental way you can think about numbers in a different way today. And tomorrow I'm going to teach you how to do quick multiplications very, very easily. Okay. Two things. The first thing today, which I'm going to teach you or talk to you guys about, is I want to show you something which is very bizarre. Okay. I want you to read this. Just give me a second. And who wants to read this sentence for me? Let's just unmute, say Sonam. Sonam Maheshwari. Hi. Sonam, can you read the sentence? I'm not this sentence. I'm just going to write something else. Yeah. Can you read this? Sonam, can you read this?
Only lagging for me, but
I know the.
How are you?
Hi, how are you? Right? Hi, let me write it again. Hi. Yeah. Okay, my handwriting is very bad, guys. Hope apologies for that. I'm just going to write it in block letters. Cool. Hi, how are you? Okay. I'm going to do something else. Maybe just unmute one of you guys again. Let's see. Anshu. Anshu, hi. Anshu, hi. How are you doing?
Hi.
Can you read this?
What is the time?
Now I'll ask you a question. I want you to tell me in which direction are we reading from and reading to? The left to the right or right to the left? How is it?
Left.
Left to the right. Yeah.
Yeah.
Does everyone agree that we read English from the left to the right? Yeah. Can I also say beginning to the ending? If that's okay. Can I say that? Can I say that we're reading from the beginning to the end? Yeah. Now let's see how we do our calculation. Can anyone tell me how to do this calculation? Who wants to run me through? Who wants to tell me how to do this calculation? Okay, Nidish.
You'd first add the ones place, which is 5 + 7 + 3, which is 15. Carry the one and then do 7 + 3 + 2 + 1, which is 13. And then the answer is 135.
So, I want you to ask you another question before you go here is Nidish, in which direction are we calculating from?
Right to the left, because you're first going to do the ones.
Can I say end to the beginning?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, guys, I just want you to observe how absurd this is. Why are we doing our calculations this way? Yeah. It's like, I'll tell you how this is like, okay? This is like, how many of you play sports here? What sports do you play? Just put it in the comment section for my reference. Okay, I see cricket, basketball, volleyball, soccer, baseball, badminton. Okay, good guys, good. Now let's say this is me, okay? I'm playing badminton. Let's say I'm playing tennis, guys. Okay. Tennis. Okay. Now, here's me. The ball is coming towards me and I'm holding the racket this way and I'm hitting the ball with the handle. Okay. If I'm hitting the ball with the handle, is there a chance that I win the point? No? No? Okay. If I punch my football, or let's say I'm playing cricket and I'm trying to hit the ball with the let's say this is the bat, this is the handle. Can I hit a six with this? No. Can I shoot a soccer penalty kick with my hand? Can I punch it into this? No, right? Which means that there is a way in which you do stuff. Yeah. Doing calculations from the right to the left is as bad as this. Do you understand? That's the only reason why we are bad at this. Yeah. We can actually change and find it fun because, I mean, I just want you to read this. This number, can everyone tell me what this number is in words? Can you type it in words of what this number is? I'm just going to write something down. Can you tell me what this number is? Everyone, just write the spelling of how do you spell this in the comment section. It's 83, right? Yeah. So it's 80 and 3. Yes. So it's 80 and 3. Do you understand that? Does everyone understand this? It's called the place value. But when we do our addition of 83 plus 35, we somehow add 3 and 5, 8. 8 and 11, and suddenly 118 comes, 118 comes, which is shocking because it doesn't make sense. And now you might say, hey, this is still not that confusing. You know, when the confusion begins, the real confusion begins when you do 83 multiplied by 24. That's when you're like, 3 times this, 2, I'm going to carry 1. I don't know why. I'm going to do 4 times 8, 32, 33. And I'm going to do X or a 0 here, 6. 16, and then I'm somehow going to add these and I'm going to get the answer. Is that bizarre? Is it bizarre? It's not bizarre because you can get the answer, but it doesn't seem like a logical, easy way to do it. No, right? It's not the easiest way to do it. There are better ways. If you and something like this, right? When you're doing a subtraction of, let's say, 100 minus 23, you know how you do this? You say, hey, 0, hey, 10, hey, 9, hey, 10 again. Okay, 7. This doesn't make sense at all. Because 100 minus 23 is 100 minus 20, which is 80 minus 3, 77. Yeah? It's as simple as that. Which means that there are better ways of looking at numbers. Do you understand? A slight change, if you start holding your bat right, you're going to start hitting your aces. How can you hit your aces when you're catching your bat in reverse? That's my question. Understood? And that's my first learning, which is because tomorrow, when you do a subtraction in algebra, if you guys did algebra, any one of you, when you do subtraction in algebra, can you carry algebra? Can you do carry? Can you put an X? You can't. Yeah? When you do something with trigonometry, can you do it? No. Which is why we are used to this fairly stupid way of learning, right? And whatever. And then once we move forward, it becomes tougher because this logic does not work in higher math. Does that make sense? When you're solving equations, when you're solving patterns, when you're understanding expressions, when you're doing stuff beyond, all of these things which we learned about carry does not work. Do you understand that? There are no sort of properties, which is why we're all scared of math. We're scared of math because of the reason that math becomes, you're taught math the wrong way and the right way comes later on and it's hard for us to shift. Does that make sense? Yeah. Which is why I'm telling you guys that me in my journey, and again, and probably tell you guys and maybe the parents also here before I open up for questions, is that in my journey of becoming the world's fastest human calculator, I've learned only one very important thing. Yeah. The very important thing is that math is fun if you learn it the right way. It is horrible if you are taught on a way which is not relatable. Which is, why is 1/4 and 2/8 the same? To 1/4 and 2/8, why are they the same? Why do decimal numbers exist? Why does the number 10 come after number 9? Yeah? Why is 7 times 8 and 8 times 7 the same? What is binary? How does the computer understand math? How does your calculator do math? Yeah? These are all questions which we are never really think about. Do you agree? Do you understand that we don't talk about this as much? Do we understand that we don't understand these things much? How does computer understand computer at all? See, my first question before I probably enter, exit today's conversation is, why does the number 9, why are there only 10 math symbols? Takim, there could be more. Why are we counting the way that we are? Why could it not be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and then 10? There is no answer, right? Yet. Do you guys think about it? Yeah? I mean, you were taught, Soham, I understand that we were taught. But think of it this way. Someone thought about it first. Yeah? Yeah, I mean, there was someone who probably thought about why this should work the way it works. Like initially, human beings were counting in tally. Yes, do you agree? People were counting with putting sticks to sheep and stuff like that initially. Later, they went on to say Roman numerals. But suddenly they said there's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then 10 comes after it, like a circle. Who thought about it? If you understand who thought about it, you'll understand how computers function. Okay? And this is something which I'm going to talk to you about tomorrow. I just want you to think about, why did someone think, let's count till 0, 1, because think about it this way, that someone realized that, hey, I'm going to count 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 2, 0, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3. Would this have been wrong? No, right? It wouldn't have been wrong. But someone thought 10 was more important because we have 10 fingers. Do you understand? Someone thought 10 was cool because they're like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh, I'm done with my hands. I'm going to put a new symbol and call it 10. Does that make sense? Which means that we need to answer these questions. Why is math the way it is? And the moment you answer it, you're going to have tons of fun. And yeah, you can do that. We could have counted the other ways. If someone thought, let's count with the number of eyes we have. 0, 1, 10, 11, 20, and stuff like that. They could have done it, but they didn't. Yeah. So math is not just discovered. It's invented. You know what invented means? Someone created it. Someone created it to make life easy for us. You know how the numbers are flowing from your screen, which every one of you here is in the United States, right? Almost, or in India. Now, from your part of the country, all the bits or the hundreds of numbers are flowing to the internet, coming towards me. And I'm looking at you because math is there. If there was no math, there is no Instagram, there is no Facebook, there is no Snapchat, there is no PUBG, there is no game at all whatsoever. Which is why I would want to emphasize that math isn't everywhere. Yeah, math is everywhere. And when I say math is everywhere, it is literally everywhere. Yeah. So that's pretty much about what I wanted to tell you guys today. A little more about why we are doing this session with the Telugu Association of St. Louis is that to get hold of you guys and talk to you guys about why math is fun. And more importantly, give you guys an opportunity to be a part of the Exploring Infinity's Experiential Math Learning Program, which is a 30 to 100 session classware, where you understand math this way and become 3-4 times quicker. And when I say 3-4 times quicker, be able to do calculations like 8732 multiplied by 63 in under 5 seconds. Being able to do 874321 divided by 9 in 10 seconds. And maybe even do calculations beyond that, but also understand why math is fun. Math in computer science, math in AI, math in music, math in art, stuff like this, which I think is relevant for everyone. I'm going to open up for questions, and any parent or any student who has any question whatsoever, if you can put it in the comment section, I'll be more than happy to answer. If you can raise your hand on the video, if you can literally raise your hand on the video, I can unmute you. Siri, go on.
585 divided by 500.
Okay, that's pretty easy. That's 1.17. Thank you, Siri. Cool. Any non-math question also, guys? You can ask about anything else also whatsoever. Nidish, go on. Let's actually go to a bunch of things because I'm in my screen. I can only see a few people. But I mean, let me try to go beyond also. Yeah.
873,452 multiplied by 7,341.
5,000. No, you said 7,321.
No, 41.
Okay, I did 7,321 and I did my calculation. So I'm going to stick to that. The answer is 639,454,092.
Yeah.
Thank you. So guys, any non-math questions? Because calculations I can do. That's not a big deal. Any parent here? Who's probably has any question or anything of that sort for me, because I think this is, and most importantly, guys, I want every one of you to attend tomorrow, because tomorrow is the session where you actually learn what this stuff is. And more importantly, how you can start your journey in experiential math learning yourself. Yeah. Okay. I'm going to go to, okay, I see a bunch of people raise their hands. Mahesh. Mahesh, you have to unmute yourself.
How long did it take you to get this fast and good?
I have sort of, okay, here's the question. I did it on my own. So it took me a long, long, long time, right? It took me a bunch of years, but I don't think it'll take as long if someone's guided the right way. And that's what I do, right? Like Exploring Infinite is, that's what we do. We try to condense this into a 1-year program where kids can actually become quicker at math, but more importantly, understand the nuances of it. So I personally think, for me, it took 5 years. It doesn't necessarily have to take anyone more than a year to do this.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you. I think someone asked about word problems. Guys, I mean, anyone who's here, word problems can be tackled if you understand what math means. And I think that's the only way. You talk about why these operations work the way they work. And if you teach them that, that'll be more than great, more than enough. I see a bunch of questions coming to my private chat somehow. Okay. Guys, I mean, I've worked with a lot of them. Lot of things. And I don't use Vedic math. I actually use my own methods, which I've started off, which are very, very core math centric. And over hundreds of children across the globe have sort of started learning math this way. And I'm glad that I'm able to sort of like add on to children's learning. In fact, we have around 600 to 700 students who have moved out from Kumon and have started our courses because they're more fun. So I'm pretty proud of that. Yeah. Aryan, no. I'll tell you why. Because the left to right is just one of the many things which I was talking about. And if I have to probably say this, the understanding of a number from the left to right sort of adds on to the child's learning or understanding of numbers, because that's how higher math is. You understand things from the place values of it. So I think it's more enabling than any confusion. In fact, we've had a bunch of students who've excelled in school after they sort of did our courseware at Exploring Infinities. How did I get interested in math? That's a long story. I met with an accident at 5 years. I was bedridden for an entire year. I started picking up puzzles. When I started picking up puzzles, I loved math and how it was beyond. And from there today, I learn everything through the eyesight of math, which is be it science, be it art, or be it anything else. Okay, someone's asking me for what the programs are. Okay, that'll be great. I'll actually run you through. Just give me a minute. What else? What are the questions? Okay, I'm trying to bucket out questions so that I can answer all of them. Just give me a minute. Cool. So guys, I mean, yeah, I'm going to do that. So, So, I mean, at Exploring Infinities, we actually broadly do this. If you see, we, for children, build out, and I think this is with all the parents who send me a message, we build out building blocks, which are fundamentals of math, cognitive ability development and brain training through the math games. And we build out some contest with it, visualize geometry, talk about math behind coding and math in real life, what mathematical thinking means and how to do quick speed math. That's the route we take. And if I sort of go on this a little deeper, you'll also understand that we have pathways where the kids of the age 6 to 10 and 11 to 16 have different pathways of learning, starting from here, going into business understanding, data science, artificial intelligence, and similarly to the other walks of life. So, yeah, I mean, that's what I would say. The courses which we build out are more holistic and not only about speed, but about how children can apply the math they learn in the world around them through math games. In fact, I'll actually drop this in the comment section later on, expinfi.com/play, if you see. There's a way in which you can subscribe and get free access to games where you can play them and give it a shot. And we have our classes, as mentioned, are twice a week and happen for students across. Research internship opportunities, absolutely, guys. I mean, Parthiv and Madhav, sir, I mean, that's what I've done. I've briefly run you through those, but you can actually find more about them on expinfi.com. I'm just going to post it in the comment section. What I would also want every one of you to tell is that math is a way in which you can train your brain and also create something, right? So I believe that mathematics can be looked at as something which you can create. Now think about it. If you talk about coding, right? Coding is a way in which you write a code to make someone understand. So it's like the alphabet. Yeah? Coding is like the alphabet. But if you write a book, if you want to write a book, is alphabet enough? Can you write a book with only knowing the alphabet? Not really. So you need to know how to build out logic and stuff like that, which is why I think math is the most important thing there is. I've posted the link in the comment section, guys. Yes. And any other queries from everyone? If there isn't, what I would also want you to request every one of you to do, I'll probably pin this comment here, is I want all of you to, to just fill out this form about your feedback and see how you guys are. But more or less, maybe I would want to understand your rating, how you like the class. This is 5, which is very good, all the way till, let's say, 1, and not really. So on this scale, maybe just put in your annotations. I just want to know. Annotate on the screen, maybe, on how you liked it. If you liked it a lot, just give a stamp here or something. Yeah, if you can do that. I have allowed you for the annotations. Fantastic, guys. Fantastic. Oh, much better. Much better. I've gotten the results in the comment section. Cool. Thanks a lot. And yeah, does anyone have any queries here? Anyone? Okay. So just a second. I'm just going to scroll through the comment section. The age group for the kids to start our program is 6 to 16, everyone. It's from the age of 5 to 6, all the way till 16. That's the age group, which I generally think is the place where you rightly start the journey of the child in mathematics. No, I think I'm actually feedback link. I'm sending it again. There is a thing problem there. And guys, everyone who's interested to, let's say, join or understand about the courseware in the long run, please join tomorrow, because tomorrow is going to be more of a session where I teach you guys how to do this. Okay. And I think it's almost an hour now. So I think I'll pass it on slowly to the TAS group. But I just want everyone to fill out these feedback forms. And maybe just turn up tomorrow if you're interested, because tomorrow is going to be the class where we actually learn. And from there, you'll take it forward. You can visit expinfi.com to understand more about the products which we have and stuff like that. But do fill out this form. Do fill out this form of feedback so that we understand about, let's say, your take. And please join tomorrow. Yeah, anything else from anyone? Any other doubts so far? Abhi, go on.
Can I ask you like a math question?
Math question, sure. We can, no problem.
Okay,
700,000.
No,
Abhi, I'm losing you. 7 million.
78,452,182 times 600.
Times 600, that should be 40. Okay, let me think. That should be 47,071,309,200.
Yeah, that was correct.
Awesome.
Thank you. And for all the people who are asking me about the courseware of Exploring Infinity, tomorrow's session is free, guys. So hope every one of you attends that. And I think the course has its own... I do know Telugu, guys. Namaskaram andarki. I can understand and I'm from here. I'm from Hyderabad myself. So I mean, all the classes which Exploring Infinity takes are by lead trainers whom I've trained, who go for 30 sessions, give you access to games, a lot of other stuff. So I hope to see you, a lot of you guys there. And there is a... Yeah, so I think tomorrow, please do attend though. Like, that's the major and the more important thing. Tomorrow, it's at the same time. Same time as now. Same time as today, right? I think Raja Garu.
Yes. Onandi.
On to you, sir.
Yeah.
On to you, sir. I think I'm done with mine. Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Thanks, Bonagaru. Thanks. It's a wonderful session. Thanks to all parents and kids. Yeah, please join us tomorrow at 10 o'clock. And we'll see you there. Thanks a lot.
And do fill the feedback form, everyone. Do fill the feedback form before you go. Make sure that you attend tomorrow if you're interested into what Exploring Infinities does. And more importantly, if you want to be a part of these, let's say, this is the feedback form, go for it. And also Math Wizard is the course, which is for kids of the age 6 to 10. You can actually go through it in the website. You can scroll below and find the sort of, let's say, the curriculum and stuff like that. So hopefully I'll see you guys on the other side in a little while. Yeah? Cool.
Yeah.
Hope you've had fun and looking forward to see you guys there. And for all the parents, please do reach out if you think that this, you would want to, let's say, start your journey or embark on your journey of your child to make math fun and more interesting. That's the most important part. I think that's what something which we lack in general as a society. Yeah. Sure, sir. On to you.
Thank you. Thanks a lot. Thanks, everyone. See you tomorrow. Bye.
Bye-bye, guys. Bye-bye. And for everyone who's here who messaged me, you can follow me on Instagram at the fastest human calculator if you would want to, let's say, get in touch or anything of that sort. See you guys. Bye-bye.